Welcome back on this mid-afternoon now in the greater Bloomington metropolitan area after 2 inches of rain last night. I tried to do a live stream, but it's third-party bullshit, and every time something interrupts, the fucking shit cuts off and it fucks it up. But what I was saying was this little dotted line was all these fucking jabronis that were on here all through Facebook last night today claiming that they called Saturday Night Live perfect. They're fucking jabronis. These fucking people are lying to you, and they're the same people that lie and manipulate you like the criminal, gangster, bankster cartels that have taken over and hijacked the U.S. government and the world monetary and fiscal policies that continue to drive the average American and the average person around the world into a working slave mentality on a shittier standard of living and a higher quality, a shittier standard of living, longer work hours, less pay. And it's by the same bullshit, lack of critical thinking in the mass population that these predators prey on. They tell you something and lie and then say the opposite and say they were right. And everyone's just like, oh my God, they were right. Are you fucking people a bunch of jabronis? These guys told you when Elon Musk last night came on, you were going to have 100% fucking pump. Are you listening to me? They said 100 fucking percent pump. And they had you buying all week last week in here, right? Oh, they had you loading up in there. Loading the fuck up in there on Friday and Saturday. Because you were expected the fucking price to be, and this is just going to be a quick video because it just bothers me when people come on and say they're right and they shiest and shaft and hose the audience. And like, subscribe, and share, hit the bell notification so you can get emergency updates like this and great content and entertainment. And I appreciate my new subscribers. I see 2 new subscribers this morning. We're up to, I believe, 34 subscribers. I appreciate every single one of you. And that's what we put these emergency alert videos out for, and keep you one step ahead of the criminal bankster cartel that control the monetary and fiscal policies that dictate the markets that help and control the manipulation in the stock market, the commodities market, and in the crypto market. That's why we gave you that emergency video about what was going to happen on Saturday Night Live 3 days ago. We said it was going to crash during Saturday Night Live. No, we didn't say the coin was going to zero. No, we didn't say the coin was going to 10 cents. No, we didn't say you guys were going to go bankrupt. But yes, we did say at Vincenzo's Gold Crypto Investing that it was going to crash during Saturday Night Live. We didn't say how long the crash would last. We would determine that as the price moved after. But we said it was going to crash. And what did it do? 44%. And you say, well, the price is coming back up, so no harm, no foul. Well, there is harm and there is foul for people that were telling you you were going to have an immediate pump and it was going to go, Elon was going to come on and bam, the price was going to all of a sudden be up here now, 60, 70% higher. So what do people do? They throw a lot of money in there. They average a lot higher up on their positions. If they have already owned a lot, they did a lot of averaging up the other night. And when they averaged up with leverage. That's why the price could crash and get liquidated so fast, so quick in a flash crash. Because all these people levered up, because all these jabronis and scumbags and fucking, can you fucking believe these scumbags? Last night on YouTube, these motherfuckers told these hard-earned followers and subscribers and these diehards to fucking load up on Dogecoin. Fucking Dogecoin. Can you believe a coin called fucking Doge? They told them to load up at 60 and 70 fucking cents when they weren't buying at 10, 20, or 30 because a fucking Elon Musk was going to wear a hat of a dog and a D on it. So all of a sudden, the fucking price, are you fucking people stupid? Are you that fucking dumb to think a price was going to pump by 100% because a guy was going to wear something on his head? You guys are fucked. And if you believe that, you're lost. But you guys don't. That's why you're here and you were updated and you didn't buy in on the hype. I did not recommend buying in on the hype Thursday, Friday, or Saturday. I said it was going to crash Saturday night. I didn't say it was going to go to zero. Our little friend over here. All right, let's pull our friend up. See that guy? See that guy right there? Can y'all see him? I can see him. That guy right there, that's our hunter. He shoots the ducks as they peek their head over the wall. But he, and we put him there last night because we said he was waiting for Saturday Night Live last night. And he was going to shoot him in the fucking head. And what did he do? He fucking shot you guys in the head. He didn't say he's not the coin killer. He just said he was the Saturday Night Live hype killer, and he was. So all those fucking jabronis that are saying they were right, they were wrong. We are the only company that was out there saying it was going to dump during Saturday Night Live. And if you would have took our advice, you could have bought these lower levels and then speculated if you wanted to gamble. But if you're a long-term hodler, who gives a fuck? And then these guys that come on there and they tell you to buy at 70 cents and then it drops. So they say average down and then it comes up a little bit close to their new average down price. So they sell, right? And then the price tanks again and then they buy and then it pumps. And then somewhere here, unless it flash crashes, they're going to sell it, hopefully a profit that they're telling you to do. Why the fuck would you do that? You're paying the highest fucking taxes possible. Because you're buying it and selling it, taxes. Then you're buying it and selling it again, taxes. Anytime you buy and trade, sell, exchange crypto for anything else other than just buying it, you have to pay taxes on that transfer. So even if you didn't make fucking money on it, you got to pay fucking taxes on it. Because that's how they tax crypto too. It's not just capital gains tax on crypto. In the U.S., in other countries, it's a lot different. They don't even have taxes in most countries. But my United States audience, if you buy Bitcoin and then take Bitcoin and transfer it to Litecoin, that part of the transaction that you took from Bitcoin to Litecoin is taxed as a transaction. Okay, just so you know that. Sign your taxes. It's class one felony to lie about it. But you're paying the most fucking taxes possible. Robert Kiyosaki would be slapping the fucking shit out of you guys right now. Rich Dad, Poor Dad. I highly recommend all my audience read their books. Like, subscribe, and share. Hit the bell notification so you get all my vital alerts. We appreciate our new subscribers, two of them today. If we can get to 100 subscribers by next weekend, I would be very grateful. And if we hit 100 subscribers by next Saturday, I will give on a special emergency announcement on this video. I will transfer somebody $25 in their favorite crypto if we get 100 subscribers by next Saturday. Okay? 100 subscribers. I'll put a random drawing into our from all of our 100 subscribers, and then I will get a hold of that person and I will transfer $20 in Bitcoin to their wallet if we make 100 subscribers by next Friday. But, oh, look at the current price. But like we were saying, it's got the price in the old tower. I ain't doing shit. But we weren't, this guy back here, the hunter, you know, our favorite duck hunter, right? He wasn't the coin killer. He was just, like I said, the Saturday Night Live killer. So this company in office did not say Dogecoin was going to zero or get out. We were just saying Saturday Night Live was going to be a bust. And we believe we are in a topping reversal pattern, a blow-off topping localized reversing pattern. And we do think we're going to come down to the 20-cent level. Eventually. Not tomorrow, maybe not next week. It could go up higher. Who knows from here? All this office knows is we called that Saturday Night Live perfectly. And we're gloating because the price is not sitting at 80. If the price last night or this morning was sitting at 90 cents a dollar and didn't dip 48%, I would say we were wrong. But when it did that and the price is sitting right there, that's a long way from right there, and that's a long way from doing that, right? So we saved our subscribers the headache of trying to fight back and wonder if they were just going to break even after the trade and not have to buy and sell, pay tax, pay tax, pay tax, pay tax, lose money, and fees, the fucking fees with it. You know, you got to pay all these fucking fees too. If you're buying this fucking coin, buy it and hodl it. But why are you fucking trying to trade it between 60 cents and 50 cents when you could have just bought the fucking thing down there and held it and then just bought more if it trickled down a lot lower than wherever the fuck you bought it at? You know what I'm saying? We don't recommend doing that. Just buy it and hold it if you want to. We never said don't buy it. We just said don't buy it leading up to the hype. for Saturday Night Live at the top of those wicks and the candles, you know, because those are 30% higher than the base, than the running mean of the price. See what I'm saying? Now, it's up to you, but look at that big red candle. You know, that's an engulfing red candle in volume in the daily time frame. If that doesn't turn around, that could be a signifying a local top, right? And you see our volume where it peaked over here. It's been crashing ever since. And as it's been doing that, you've had a rising and constricting price with falling volume. That's usually bearish and usually signifies the pattern is being exhausted. Yeah, the price can still go up a lot during that. You know what I'm saying? You're in a range. That's called a rising channel, right? That's what that's called. You have upper resistance and lower support. And the upper resistance, you get higher lows on the way up. Higher lows, higher lows, higher lows, higher lows. Here, we'll make this a little better for you. We'll show you what we're currently in. It's a rising channel. And those are usually bearish patterns when you have falling volume and a rising channel, right? Those are usually bearish. And you say, well, let's go to the 4-hourly, get us some more candles. You say, well, how do we figure out targets in a rising channel? Well, it's pretty fucking easy. You got to try to find your support and your resistance. We'll see, our running support and resistance was there, right? We'll pull another one out. That's our support. Then you got to find your resistance, which you could say was running good right there. Go to the daily time frame. Yeah, this is a daily time frame pattern. So if you make this and you zoom in, it's going to look different. Like where all these are going to meet, support and resistance lines aren't going to look the same because this is a daily time frame pattern. But you can see when we entered this, let's actually zoom out real quick. When we entered this off of a top right here and we peaked in volume and then we consolidated down with falling volume, that was good. Falling volume consolidation is bullish. But then you see the price, the volume now is rising a little bit, but it topped here and now is crashing. But this was sell volume. But the volume overall is trended down. So an overall trending down volume in a rising channel where the peaking volume happened. Let me just clear this fucking shit off. Can you fucking believe that? He said peaking volume. Yeah, I said fucking peaking volume. You remember that. Fucking peaking volume. When you have that peaking volume right there, and then your local top, and you can see that's not too much lower than where we're at now. And then you get into this fucking channel. This fucking rising channel. This fucking guy drew a rising channel. I know he fucking drew a rising channel because I drew it. Then you get into a rising channel with falling volume. And you hit resistance 2, whole steam of resistance, and upper resistance 3, 4, 5. And every time you see, critical thing to pay attention to here, every time you see, let me get this shit out so you can see it better. Every time you see these candles up here, when you're hitting the top part in the daily candles, these are daily candles. This isn't minute, 5 minute, hourly, or 4 hourly. These are daily candles. Anytime you're seeing a pump in the daily, right? The daily candle, and then a long wick at the top. See that long wick? We need to change that color. Get it to a color we can see. See how you have a long wick here, and then it's down, and then the body of the candle is down there? That means when it closed, you closed down low, right? You closed off the high of the day. That was the high of the day, and then you closed lower, right? And every day you did that, you see that 1 day, 2 day, 3 day, every fucking day, it had the same thing on those wicks. 1, 2, let's get our little pointer tool out here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times you hit this upper resistance. Upper resistance hit 5 times. And all five times you had heavy sell pressure at the top end of those candles. That's signifying a top. Usually, if you're trying to read the Heikinashi candle, that's a sell. That's a topping signal. Let's get some of this shit off again. Anytime you see a long wick at the top in a daily candle time frame, and the base of the candle, right? The base of the candle, and you say, what's a base of a candle? Fuck your base of a candle. That's your base of the candle. Anytime you see that base depressed down from the top of the candle wick, right? Top of the candle wick. Anytime you see that, that's bearish. That's saying there's a lot of sell pressure and it can't hold its gains, right? In the rising channel as we hit that upper resistance. So what that would tell you after hitting all of this support back here, when you hit that upper resistance with them high wicks and then suppressed candle body, that's telling you you're probably going to at the very least roll over and retest the bottom support now of this rising channel. But we know rising channels and falling volume overall is bearish. Rising channels in general are bearish. They're bearish reversal patterns, and the target move out of a bearish reversal pattern in the daily time frame would be very low. Nobody on YouTube right now or that is invested in Doge would like, if this was a rising channel and that's actually what we're in the daily time frame, nobody would like the target move out of that, because the target move out of a rising channel is the bottom of the channel. And where the fuck did the bottom of the channel start? Right there. 26 cents to 20 cents. And that's why we have our buy box got taken out of there. But if you watch our other videos, we have an ultimate buy zone down there. Files to advantage. Who cares? Who cares about that? We have an ultimate buy zone down there for a reason. Because at VINCENZO’S Gold Crypto Investing Probability Based One of a Kind House Model Forecast System that we use has seen this. And we are paying close attention. And that's it for our update. Like, subscribe, and share. VINCENZO’S Gold Crypto Investing.